Welcome to the Blizzard Brawl Weekend Edition of the Pro Wrestling Report Primetime TV for December 7th, 2013. Coming up next, it's this week's TV Highs and Lows, DHHS, the Event Center, and our thoughts on the impossible matches announced for CM Punk and Daniel Bryan at TLC. But first, it's time to take a look at the dynamics behind the match up to unify the WWE and World Championships between John Cena and Randy Orton in this week's Big Story.
Thank you, Linda. Damian Nelson sitting alongside David Octavius Tiberius, the alleged backyard one-time knockout, straight-edge hardcore Hall of Famer hero.
Yes.
Here on Saturday night, December 7, 2013. Thank you for joining us wherever you are, and let's get right down to it. This week's big story, ladies and gentlemen. You voted for it this past Monday night. You voted for it to be called the Unified Championship.
Really?
When the WWE and World Heavyweight Championships are unified and combined at WWE TLC on pay-per-view.
That doesn't sound sexy, does it?
Not at all.
Not at all.
The two participants in this unification matchup have 25 World or WWE championships between them, John Cena and Randy Orton. Now, what I did like this past Monday night in the build to this matchup was John Cena and his very pointed comments at Randy Orton. One could say there was a bit of realism in them as he said that Orton got successful, got cocky, gained a bad attitude, and got lazy, David.
Well, he was pretty much dead on honest with everything that he said. All those things that John Cena said, everyone else has been saying for the last couple years.
Including Randy Orton himself in his digital video versatile disc, DVD, that was released.
You can only tear up so many hotel rooms.
This match will apparently happen on December 15th at TLC, but here's the question.
Wait, next week already?
Yeah, it is next week.
Good God Almighty.
Here's the question. Are we on our way to a Cena or Orton, depending on who wins the match at TLC? Well, let's back up a little bit. Who will win that matchup, David Hero? We're going to book it, of course, soon, but who will win that matchup? If you were a booking man, John Cena or Randy Orton, and which championship do they walk out of TLC with?
If I'm given the pencil for this match, there's no way I cannot have Randy Orton not become the unified world champion.
Randy Orton.
Randy Orton. John Cena's already the big star. He's already going to have a big match at WrestleMania. You need Randy Orton to be elevated so now he's on par with John Cena. The only way that can happen is to beat John Cena and grab both of those title belts.
So let's say Randy Orton does walk out the unified champion at a December pay-per-view some 12 years after WWE has done it before. What happens next? What's the end game is the question. Is it going to be Randy Orton, the legend killer, the WWE champion, the unified champion, versus The Streak and The Undertaker at WrestleMania? This is likely to be Undertaker's final.
No, because whoever wins the Royal Rumble is the guy that's going to get the title shot.
But will they really? Because you've got Elimination Chamber in Minneapolis in between those two pay-per-views. They've easily walked away from the Rumble winner in the past getting a championship shot. They can do that again if they need to. I feel, as we talked about yesterday in our online edition of PWR, there's going to be some shenanigans.
What?
Come TLC. You got to explain those shenanigans at the Royal Rumble. You got to fix those shenanigans at Elimination Chamber to get to WrestleMania.
Winning the Rumble to get the title match at WrestleMania. They're not going to change that formula at all.
They won't change that formula for the Rumble, David, but by the time WrestleMania rolls around, that doesn't necessarily still need to be the formula.
Well, it could be, but you know, Randy Orton's going to leave TLC the champion. John Cena can then go on and do whatever he has to do at the Rumble. You know, there's
win it.
He could, very well could.
That's how you get to your rematch?
That's how you get to your rematch.
You know what, that makes some sense.
And that keeps them apart also, where then Randy Orton can build some steam with some other guys, building steam going to WrestleMania to face John Cena.
So let's say it's John Cena that wins. Would you be intrigued by a championship versus streak match between those two? As Undertaker has said in the past, that John Cena is one guy he wants to have a matchup with at Mania.
The only guy I want to see Undertaker wrestle at WrestleMania is John Cena.
Really?
That's the only match I want to see.
Who wins?
I could see Taker letting Cena beat him. I could see that. I could see Cena beating
torch.
Taker.
But Cena doesn't need the torch. That's a torch passing moment. That's Hogan Andre. That's Rock Hogan.
All streaks are broken.
Uh-huh.
Okay? Mm-hmm. They all are. Eventually,
my undefeated streak in the draft will not be. But
well, no,
carry on.
But I also believe that you had streaks in your shorts after Kevin Thorne took care of you at Blizzard Brawl a couple years ago. But yeah, Cena versus Taker, that's a money match at WrestleMania. I don't think it's going to be Sting versus Taker. I don't think that has the
that's
build.
That's a money match. Which match is bigger?
I think Cena Taker is bigger than Sting Taker.
All right. Well, we'll see what happens at TLC on pay-per-view. We'll also see what happens come the Royal Rumble and WrestleMania. And I guess maybe it's a good thing that there is no clear-cut path that they're taking to those pay-per-views.
We like a little bit of shenanigans and uncertainty in wrestling.
It's time for this week's hot news, ladies and gentlemen. It's all the headlines you need in around 2 minutes or less.
Oh, you're changing the format on me today, aren't you?
Score at home. WWE star may be on his way out of the company, but you're actually still going to see him weekly. Let's explain. Mexican wrestling star Mystico, who performed in WWE as Sin Cara, is not the person who performed that same role this past Monday night, as Mystico was actually in Mexico. Sin Cara was played by Junico,
who?
A role he has also played
Junico?
When Mystico was injured.
There's way too many co's in this entire story.
It is believed that Junico will perform as Sin Cara going forward.
Well, good for Junico.
Davey Richards is making news after his debut match with WWE NXT 2 weeks ago in Orlando. Richards, formerly of Ring of Honor Wrestling, announced his departure from the Fed this past weekend, saying, and I quote, "With a heavy heart, I can announce that myself and ROH have parted ways for good, and I will not be at Final Battle. Please continue to support them and the incredible talent they have. Thanks for the memories. It was an amazing ride." This actually led to a response from Ring of Honor Wrestling, which said, and I quote, "Due to recent events, Davey Richards has been removed from the Final Battle match by ROH management due to his unprofessionalism and unreliability with the company. What should have been a farewell for now for the American Wolves will now be one for diehard Eddie Edwards." Final Battle is scheduled for next Saturday in New York.
Well, that's interesting.
TNA signs a new TV distribution deal. The company sent out the following press release last week. TNA Impact Wrestling has
Dixie didn't tweet it out?
I'm sure she did. But also they sent out this release that said TNA Impact Wrestling has continued its recent global expansion by signing a new multi-year agreement with Nippon Television Network, NTV, in Japan. NTV Channel G Plus will continue to air TNA Impact Wrestling every Saturday night at 10 p.m., as well as broadcasting TNA's monthly pay-per-view and one-night-only events. As you know, wrestling is very popular in Japan, and this is great news for TNA. PWR will keep you up to date with developments on these stories as they become available at the all-new and better PWRshow.com. That's it for this week's hot news.
Be sure to check out PWR Live every Tuesday night, streaming live at PWRshow.com, where you have the chance to call in and ask questions of the PWR team each Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Coming up after the break, we have this week's TV highlights right here on PWR Primetime TV on My24 Milwaukee.
Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh. PWR is coming for a huge Royal Rumble kickoff party featuring
Big Sexy Kevin Nash.
That's right. The night before the WWE Royal Rumble in Pittsburgh, come to PWR's kickoff party featuring all kinds of shenanigans and Big Sexy Kevin Nash. Tickets available right now at PWRshow.com. PWRshow.com, the Royal Rumble kickoff party comes to Pittsburgh.
Share your comments on tonight's stories by following along on Twitter using the hashtag PWRTV, and Damian and Dave will interact with you during the broadcast.
If you've been hurt in a car wreck, the insurance company may try to stop you from getting what's fair.
After my car wreck, the insurance company just wasn't helping me, so I said stop, and I called Gruber Law Offices.
Be careful. Call us right away.
They better be careful. Now I've got Gruber Law Offices.
Call us. Let us get started on your case right now.
They put the green light on my case and got me $65,000.
Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. Call 276-6666.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Pro Wrestling Report Primetime Saturday night here on My24 Milwaukee. Damian Nelson sitting alongside David Hero, and it is time for this week's TV highlights. TV highs from all of the week in wrestling. Let's go back to Raw for just a minute. This past Monday night, John Cena, as we talked about in the big story, David Hero, he got real with Randy Orton, but They also got real at the end of the broadcast in that big Donnybrook, that fight they had where Cena then put Orton through two different tables.
They gave away the main event for the next pay-per-view.
How so?
That was at least a good 4.5 minutes of a TLC match. Minus the ladder.
On the referee.
Yeah. Amazing. I mean, if that 3 minutes is going to be as good as the main event, then it's definitely worth buying.
John Cena went old school, if you will. And what I mean by old school is he went back to his days of his promos with The Rock leading into their big matchup at WrestleMania, where he was very serious and very real and very realistic in his words
you need
to the
that.
Viper.
You need that. If you're going to sell this match, you need to bring some realism into it. You want to make it show that there's a want, need, and desire for John Cena to have both of those titles.
Also on Raw, there's a new number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship as Damian Sandow defeats Dolph Ziggler to go after Big E Langston's championship. Good matchup. Surprised by the Sandow win. Sandow's not been as prevalent as he was when he had the Money in the Bank briefcase.
It was a very good match, but the thing that was very Kabuki-ish to me is that the last 2 weeks they've had two gimmick matches, like hardcore-style matches. Now, this week they have a regular wrestling match, and Damian Sandow beats Dolph Ziggler in a regular wrestling match. You would think Dolph Ziggler would have shined over Damian Sandow.
Well, Dolph Ziggler always shines when he's in the ring.
But he didn't win.
He's endorsed.
He's not the number one contender to Biggie Langston's title
at this point.
No, he's not.
Let's say that match happens at TLC. Who walks out with the Intercontinental strap?
You got to believe that Biggie Langston's the guy they're going to run with for a little while.
Also on Raw, Sin Cara gets a big pinfall victory over Alberto Del Rio, clean in the center of the ring. What does this mean, David Hero?
It means ADR definitely needs Ricardo Rodriguez back in his corner. Ever since Ricardo has left, Del Rio's career has just taken a free fall.
Well, he's on the Spanish broadcast team now.
He needs Ricardo back.
Alberto Del Rio, though, on Friday Night SmackDown, took his frustration out on Kofi Kingston, destroying him before their matchup even
began. Kofi has just been a whooping boy lately, hasn't he? I mean, The Miz is owning him, Del Rio is owning him. It's not a good time to be Kofi Kingston.
Also on Raw this past Monday night, Bray Wyatt, that promo he cut, convinced me that he may just turn Daniel Bryan.
Huh?
Daniel Bryan may just end up being an honorary member of the Wyatts.
I don't see that happening at all. That is a step backwards, and they're going to start the Faces of Fear with the Wyatts and then start recruiting people in there.
Thunder of Doom match.
Do you honestly think Brie Bella is going to let her fiancé join the Wyatts?
Why not?
Because.
I mean, I'm sure he's wearing the pants in that family. It's his choice.
There's no way. Brie will disown him.
The goal in wrestling is intrigue, and I'm intrigued by what Bray Wyatt said this past Monday night. Over on SmackDown, again on Raw, rather, another great matchup with The Shield and the Broads. Just tremendous tag team wrestling action from them week in and week out, even though we see them wrestle week in and week out.
You know what it is, but unfortunately what's going to happen is that the fans are going to start taking these good matches for granted. Because this last, Monday night was another great, great match. But how many more great, great matches do you want to see? We want to see something different.
While on SmackDown this past Friday night, we did see something a little different from what we've seen recently, which was a matchup between two great performers, that in CM Punk and the United States champion Dean Ambrose. CM Punk getting a victory with the go to sleep in what was a tremendous matchup, even though it wasn't for the United States championship. I like what they did there.
But once again, the U.S. champion loses a non-title match.
Well, maybe they'll go on to TLC and have that matchup. Remember, Punk and Shield have a little bit of a story going on.
They do have history, but they could have put Seth Rollins in that and protect the U.S. champion.
But it was a non-title match.
But they always lose non-title matches. Protect the title.
Speaking of titles, over on Impact Wrestling this past Thursday night, the championship tournament to determine a new TNA World Champion continued with Magnus defeating Kurt Angle in a last man standing match. He thus advances in the tournament. He will take on Jeff Hardy.
Very interesting. Of course, Bobby Roode getting involved, mm-hmm. Shenanigans. But Magnus in the finals of the TNA Impact Wrestling World Title Tournament. That's kind of shocking.
Kind of shocking for sure.
Not I really thought it was going to be Kurt Angle was going to be in the finals of that.
Is this a good move by TNA then, doing this with Magnus as opposed to Kurt Angle, because that was the obvious choice?
I don't know,
choice.
Because, Kurt Angle turned down his Hall of Fame because mm-hmm. he hadn't done enough, is what he said. Since he's turned on that Hall of Fame, he has yet to win a match, hasn't he?
It's true.
He's been struggling.
How about that disqualification in the tag team championship matchup as the bromans, Robbie E. and Jesse Godders, with their DJ, Zema Ion, defeated James Storm and Gunner after Gunner took out the
referee? Who would have thought the bromans would become the most dominant tag team in TNA Impact Wrestling?
I certainly wouldn't have.
It's because you don't like the romance, that's why.
This week's TV highs, David Hero. Anything else tickle your fancy from wrestling TV this past week?
No, I think that was pretty good. I think you covered everything there was to cover.
Well, let's see what is in store for us in this week's Diamond of the Ring segment, David. Tell us who was the best of the best.
I will say this. This week's Robert Hack Diamond of the Ring was a coin flip for me. I wasn't too sure if I wanted to go with Sin Hunico or EC3 from TNA Impact Wrestling. EC3 has just been dominating on TNA Impact Wrestling. He's got a great look, good attitude. He has that it factor about him. Defeats
Jason Bateman, Ethan Carter, the third. I don't think. But that's your Diamond of the Ring?
Absolutely.
I'm shocked. Hey, you know he's in TNA, Impact
Wrestling. Whenever you can defeat Earl Hebner clean on primetime television,
Brett, folks.
You know, that's a big victory. So Ethan Carter the third is this week's Robert Hack Diamond of the Ring, the place where they pay cash for gold, EC3. How about that?
Solid choice. Let's throw it over to Studio B with Linda Kay with this week's Event Center. Linda, take it away.
Welcome to the PWR Event Center, brought to you by Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. Ring of Honor Wrestling is returning to Milwaukee's Turner Hall on March 7th, 2014, and tickets are on sale now at ROHWrestling.com. PWR and CSR are teaming up with Synamic D to bring you the Royal Rumble kickoff party hosted by Big Sexy Kevin Nash at Latitude 40 in Pittsburgh. Will also serve as the official ROH after party following their big event that same night. Tickets and details are available now at pwrshow.com. That's it for this week's Event Center presented by Gruber Law Offices. And now let's find out what Arda's got in store for us in this week's The Little Things.
Yes, it's time for hashtag The Little Things. A SmackDown recap on Raw? Wow. Mind blown. Also, Kane speaking eloquently. I love it. That'll make me happy for at least 3 more weeks. Finally, Wade Barrett, Bad News Barrett, loved the segment. However, the first thing he does on the first segment of Bad News Barrett on Raw, he delivers good news. Find my article. I interview Sergeant Slaughter on the Baltimore Sun. He has some very interesting tidbits. Go ahead and read it. Hashtag the little things. By the way, that's an owl.
Well, thank you, Arda, for sharing your little things with us. But now it's time for DHHS, and Monday Night Raw and SmackDown seem to be, to me, like they're on cruise control, or even a version of Groundhog Day. The show seems the same, with the same talent and the same matches, just different placements on the show. It's pretty obvious that the WWE is still uncertain what young stars they want to give the green light to. It's like hurry up and wait with a new star every couple of weeks. From Dolph Ziggler to Fandango to Damian Sandow to Curtis Axel, the WWE has started and stopped them more than one can count. If the powers that be behind them can't get behind them, then why should the WWE universe? And with that, David Hero has spoken.
Don't forget to join PWR on Facebook, where you can get news updates, live pay-per-view coverage, and more. Head over to facebook.com/PWRshow and like PWR on Facebook now. Coming up after the break, in just over 60 seconds, we have this week's TV lows and the countout right here on My24 Milwaukee.
Who do you trust when selling your gold, silver, and diamonds? Robert Hack Diamonds was secret shopped by the media, and they found out that Robert Hack Diamonds offer the most for their jewelry. At Robert Hack Diamonds, we'll treat you like family. Shop around before you sell. If we can't beat a competitor's offer on your scrap gold, we'll give you $20 just for trying.
Bring your gold, I'll get you some money.
Robert Hack Diamonds is located at 76 and Layton in Greenfield, and our newest location on the corner of Green Tree and Port Washington Road in Glendale.
I went on down to the Audubon Zoo, and they all asked for you. They all asked for you. Who? Well, even in quiet spot,
Share your comments on tonight's stories by following along on Twitter using the hashtag PWRTV, and Damian and Dave will interact with you during the broadcast.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Pro Wrestling Report Primetime Saturday night here on My 24 Milwaukee. Damian Nelson sitting alongside David Hero. And David, big announcement. You just saw it. The Wrestling Awards. The 2013 Wrestling Awards coming on January 4th right here to My 24 Milwaukee. It's a new era, I guess you can call it, for the honors, which we've done since this show has been on air. It's the Wrestling Awards. Voting right now. Facebook.com/PWR show. Facebook.com/PWR show.
So you're going to let the peoples, the humanoids,
yes,
vote? You trust them over me
everywhere
to pick
but
a winner?
Ohio and Florida, yes.
Well, you've always had issues in Ohio and Florida, haven't you?
Let's go to this week's TV lows, the lowlights of wrestling TV this week. And this one's sort of on the fence, folks. I'm not sure where it should fall because I might like it, but I don't think I do. So the good news is I might like it. The bad news is I don't think I do. Bad news, Barrett, David Hero, at the Raw General Manager podium.
I don't like it at all. And it's simple because it doesn't grab my attention. He's standing there. I can honestly say I was watching Raw. I don't remember any of the bad news he was talking about.
Something about Oklahoma City. The second one was better than the first one.
But
you don't see potential? You don't see any guiding light?
No, because he's not antagonizing anybody. He's not trying to call anybody out. He's not turning any heat on himself.
So picture it, Sicily. Mid-match, Bad News Barrett is at ringside. He just starts talking.
Did you say Sicily?
Yeah.
Okay.
1947. It starts bad-mouthing somebody. That leads into a feud, an angle, a fight, a match. Potential?
I don't know. This is the third reboot now on Wade Barrett?
Yeah. Great talent. Just needs that
but
right hook.
You know what, though? But let's face it, Dolph Ziggler's had three or four, you know, also reboots.
Speaking of reboots, Daniel Bryan was rebooted this past Monday night on Raw. Remember, last week, he was kidnapped by the Wyatt family. Did anybody tell us where he was or how he got back or how that all...
Or there was no 911 call from Brie that was released to say her concern or whatnot? I mean... Details. I'm surprised that they would forget those details because they used to be so good at laying backstories.
Mm-hmm. Or maybe it's going to come later because, as I said earlier, it seemed like Daniel Bryan was considering Bray Wyatt's proposal.
No, it's too late. They can't talk about it next week because it's the Slammies. He's not going to bring
Posted
up...
Hosted by Jerry Lawler and Booker T.
That should be interesting.
Should indeed be interesting. And last night on SmackDown, you know, Daniel Bryan in the main event against Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt getting involved with that again.
Amazing.
As well.
So a match that headlined two pay-per-views is now main eventing SmackDown. And then you have the guy that was in the last main event on the pay-per-view is now teaming with the smallest guy in the company on SmackDown.
That'd be Big Show and Rey Mysterio.
Big Show and Rey Mysterio defeating the Real Americans. That, for me, is a TV low because the Real Americans are very solid.
Another TV low, speaking of tag team wrestling, Ryback and Curtis Axel, who for the second week in a row were already in the ring when we came back from commercial break, against Kingston and The Miz. Who cared?
No, they didn't. They beat... the Broadses in the non-title match.
No, they didn't.
On SmackDown?
No, Raw.
Oh, Raw. Oh, see, that's a TV low because you're confusing me
now. I'm not talking about the matchup on SmackDown because Cody lost.
Well, yeah. But your boy The Miz, it's not surprising. That's a TV low all in itself.
Finally in the TV lows this week, I tuned in again to Total Divas this past Sunday on E! Ugh.
It reminded you of yourself, didn't it?
My house does look similar to John Cena's, yes. Uh-huh. I only have one hamper in my bed. Who needs two dishwashers?
You have a hamster in your bedroom?
Who needs...
Is that... You have one, you said?
who needs two dishwashers?
Well, one for the wine glasses. On the gentle side.
What do you think of Divas, Total Divas? You liking it? You watching it?
You know what? Cal and I used to watch it. He has now stopped watching.
Why?
Because it's become too adult-orientated, where he's uncomfortable watching it.
That's this week's TV Lows, ladies and gentlemen. It's time now to go to this week's Count Out, the final stop on this journey that is PWR Primetime. And this week's subject, both Daniel Bryan and CM Punk, we learned this past Monday night on Raw, I think Kane made the matches, that it will be handicap matches. It will be Daniel Bryan versus the Wyatts and CM Punk versus the Shield. Now, this led to a very bizarre promo by CM Punk, who admitted he won't even win the match. You've got some interesting story between these people. But at the same time, why book a match where the finish is so obvious that one man can't beat three dominant players
in
either scenario?
You know why? Because they haven't built up anybody else to team with Daniel Bryan or CM Punk to take on these guys. They're not going to book Kofi. They're not going to book Miz with them. They're not going to book Ryback with them. There's no one to team with these guys. It's roster depth. It's also another way to get more sympathy for the baby faces. And I'm concerned about Daniel Bryan. He's had a hard enough time beating any one of the Wyatts on his own. And he's a former world champion. Now he's going to be taking on all three of them. CM Punk is a little more crafty. I think he could possibly beat the Shield, and that's how they may dissolve, is by losing that match.
You're ready to break the Shield up this fast?
I don't want to, but I could see it happening.
Really?
DLC, absolutely.
Why not wait till the Rumble? You could easily do it then. There's three entrants right there.
No, maybe that's where it starts. Maybe the Rumble is where it becomes.
Here's the thing about WWE, and one keynote, and while we've said many times in this program, sometimes the ratings don't matter. In this case, it does, because this past Monday on Raw, WWE lost 600,000 viewers to the prior week, meaning 600,000 fewer people tuned into Raw this past Monday night than they did last week. Now, last week was coming right off the heels of the Survivor Series.
But it was also a really good football game. You had the Saints.
Soccer?
And the Seahawks. Big game.
That is true, and that does explain a good portion of it. But is the writing on the wall and we're just not seeing it? We've said many a time that in wrestling, it's right in front of you if you choose to see it.
You know,
we've been bashing WWE for a couple of weeks now about the product being somewhat stale and uninteresting. Is there something brewing here that we're not seeing that's going to culminate at either TLC or the Royal Rumble in January?
If it does, it has to be at the Rumble, because I don't think the buy rates for TLC are going to be that strong. It's right in the middle of the holiday season. People are spending a lot of money on Christmas and the holidays. I don't know if they're going to invest $55 into a pay-per-view. It has to be the Rumble.
Would you be unifying the championships if you were booking things in WWE on a December pay-per-view in 2013 leading into WrestleMania 30?
I would have to, because the last three pay-per-views have been stinkers as far as buy rates. You need to get the fans back into it. This is the only match that's going to draw, and I don't know if it's the timing isn't right for it. I think it's a sign of desperation.
That's the count out, folks. And remember, head on over to our Facebook page, facebook.com/PWR show, to vote in the Wrestling Awards, which come to you in just a few weeks' time right here on My24. And next week, a very special edition of Primetime as we bring you the Blizzard Brawl post show featuring Matt Hardy, Ken Anderson, Shane Helms in action right here on Primetime Wrestling. Next week on Primetime here on My24 Milwaukee. For that one.
This one.
This is Damian Nelson saying thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you next week for the Blizzard Brawl Post Show.